Before we begin today's program, a couple of announcements. Please ensure your phones are switched off or are on silent mode. This is a courtesy extended to the others seated around you. Please do not come up to take pictures as it may distract our children. We want all the sparkles and flashes to come up from the stage. Our official photographer, Mr. Sarvanan, will cover the entire program. Your children are in safe hands, so we request you to sit back, relax, and enjoy the program so as to not disturb the ambience. The program today will conclude with the national anthem, after which you will be informed regarding the pickup of your children. Please note that the children will not be sent during the program. In case any child is uncomfortable, that child will be handed to the parents by our school staff. Thank you for your understanding.
Cycle. To keep your balance, you must keep moving.
That is quite interesting.
Hey. Just because we said the word cycle, it doesn't mean we meant it literally.
Understand the meaning of the good, my friend.
Everything turns in circles and spirals with cosmic heart until infinity. Everything has a vibration that spirals inward or outward together in the same direction at the same time. This vibration keeps going. It emerges and expands or closes and disrupts, only to repeat the cycle again. Such is the story of the sun and moon, of you and me and everything around. All energy simply transforms. Cycles, what goes around, comes around. Our theme for today's program. We, the children of Sprouts, are eager and energized to showcase cycles in different areas. We are sure you are super excited to know further details.
We begin today's event by first invoking the blessings of the Almighty. Friends, Sprouts could not function smoothly without their signing, but committed efforts of Akkas and Annas are constantly on call, handling numerous things. This team of dedicated, helpful, and hardworking staff comprises of 14 Akkas and 2 watchmen. This year, we invite our senior Akkas and Annas to light the lamp. We request Komla Akka, Savitri Akka, Menaka Akka, Manohar Anna, and Mari Akka to the stage, please. Mari Akka is the coordinator of Nishkam Trust and an important person in the Sprouts family. Thank you, Akkas and Annas.
Now, I would like to call Aishwarya ma'am on stage. She is going to read to all a very interesting letter. Further details will be told by her. Stay tuned.
Good morning. Dear parents, how are you? We at Sprouts are delighted to see you all here today. This is one day when the whole school gets together. This letter is not an invitation to a workshop, nor a reminder to send your children in traditional attire for a celebration. We just thought we'd catch up with you on something else. Some thoughts, a couple of questions maybe. First and foremost, thank you for trusting Sprouts with your children. They mean the world to us. They work, play, and grow with us very beautifully. And this is something that you can see too. Every day, you ask your children, what did you do today? Sure, they do many things that astound us, but could we tweak that question a little bit? How did you feel today, child? Now follows a letter answering that very question. It's a letter from the children to you. It's from our busy little toddlers, our fiercely independent primary children, our exploring elementary group who discover so much, and finally, our finely maturing adolescents reaching out to the adult community to understand how to manage all that is going around them. We hope you like the letter that they wrote with smiles, actions, and movements. Aishwarya auntie was merely putting the words on paper. With lots of love and regard, Sprouts.
Thank you.
With all of you.
Thank you, Aishwarya, for the enlightening aha moments and the enriching presentation, and for giving us a glimpse of a few moments, actually not so few, not quite a few, many moments which we experience in school all the time. This journey from toddler to primary, to elementary, and now early adolescence is an amazing one. And it reminds me constantly of how everything in life keeps evolving over time. Every living thing goes through a certain life cycle. They begin their life journey either as a seed or an egg or an idea. The ultimate goal of a life cycle is the transformation that every cycle allows for the next generation to prosper. As educators, we need to continuously and consciously keep in mind that the width and span of every life cycle is different from one another. For example, a mosquito has a life cycle of 24 to 48 hours, whereas a tall redwood tree more than 1,000 years. As educators, we will not compromise with the life cycle of learning. There are hundreds of students who form a part of this chakra, each moving at a pace that is unique to him or her. As educators, we provide the right input, the space and environment for our children and observe their development and evolution into discerning, confident young individuals, imbibing all the requisite qualities that will eventually define them as mature adults, while all the time letting them set the pace for learning. I would love to apply the lessons of how a caterpillar becomes a butterfly. Let's remind ourselves that this change happens over stages, where the larva that hatches from an egg becomes a pupa, and from it emerges a butterfly, a beautiful butterfly. This process requires us to observe the process and never rush the molting process. Knowledge needs to be incubated, and this incubation will eventually mature into wisdom through life experiences and multiple inputs from family. Our institution is blessed with students who are relentless in their quest for learning, like the butterfly, relentlessly working to get rid of the pupa and stretches its wings. When the children sing together, it is magical. When they play together, it is blissful. When they eat together, it is spiritual. Thank you, parents, for inculcating good values in them. At Sprouts, we believe that nurture and care begins at home, and that is the sort of environment we strive to create at school. Dear parents, remind yourselves that the life cycle today is under threat all around the world. Globally, children are addicted to screens of every kind. Millions of children have become addicted to games on the computer or cell phone, disrupting the normal flow of a life cycle. Science has enough data to prove the negative effects of this addiction forming habit amongst children in particular. Whether we choose to admit it or not, this pattern has culminated or resulted in considerable instability. And it is in the interest of the adult to address and find alternative ways to sustain the flowering of our young sprouts, as they are the next generation and they need to be given the tools to prosper in the aforementioned cycle of life. The whole school today comes together to present to you our annual reproduction on cycles. Each one of the 260 children participating have been and are experiencing, understanding the phenomena of how a process is required for anything to blossom and beautiful explosions to happen. In this day of instant results, children are imbibing values of patience and tolerance, that everything around that nature has evolved takes its own time to incubate and we have to wait for it to blossom. I wish to share with you all one small detail which you will treasure and appreciate. Each child has inspired us to dive deeper into every such an abstract concept. Each child has embraced the whole concept of cycles, not only of their own event but also that of their friends, finding creative and innovative means to comprehend every facet of this complex phenomena that is bound to impact your lives. With this, I sincerely request each one of you to put your cell phones away for the next 2 hours as our little ones take you on a most spectacular emotional, spiritual and intellectual journey of different cycles. Nature, presented by our toddler, students, life cycles by our primary students, and time cycles by our elementary and early adolescence children. Parents, grandparents, aunts, uncles, friends, sisters and brothers, the students of Sprouts present to you cycles.
Thank you, ma'am, for your constant inspiration, motivation, and guidance, for the many avenues you create and make available for both students and staff, so that there's a space to explore self-growth in numerous areas. Thank you once again.
And now, the most awaited and the much anticipated event, Cycles. We invite you, dear audience, get on the merry-go-round of fun and joy and enjoy the journey of Cycles. What goes around, comes around with us.
In a barren and arid landscape stood a mountain, a solitary mountain. But wait, it's not for me to tell the story. You have to watch it unfold. It is a beautiful story.
Hello, everyone. I'm lovely to see all of you. I'm Brazil. I'm the narrator of this little play.
Hello, everyone. My name is Zia. I'm also a narrator for this little play. Welcome, everyone. You all look very happy.
But I'm not. But I'm not happy. Not happy.
Was lonely.
One day, one day.
was happy to see the two little birds, but where was Joy?
I am mountain, but where is Joy?
Mother cannot fly anymore. She said, we must end Anshu, then we fly to one more places. We must tell you everything.
But we got lost. But it's a first long flight.
But we found it out. Do you know what I saw?
Surely as the sun rises and planet Earth revolves around the sun, the seasons present themselves. Cold winter, happy spring, joyous summer, colorful autumn, and why say more? Welcome our little toddlers as they present the cycle of the seasons to you.
What's your favorite season? What's your favorite
majestic glaciers, snowy peaks, misty waterfalls, tumbling rivers and streams, serene lakes, endless seas, joyous rain, sultry humidity. From time immemorial, water dances to an eternal cycle, and in the process, creates, causes, revives, and energizes life on Earth. Water, most precious resource on Earth. The water cycle is presented to you by our young dancers of Primary 3. Along with the sun, air, and soil, nourishes growth. What a cycle begins with just a seed, a tiny seed. From tall trees to slender plants to tender shoots to tiny seeds, our lively youngsters of Primary 4 entertain you with the life cycle of a plant.
Thank you.
Where would we be without food? We all need food. Food to nourish, to sustain, to grow, to become healthy and strong. With ingredients from the sun, from water, from air and soil, Mother Nature has created a system within each and every plant that works to perfection. Watch a factory called photosynthesis come alive with the children of Primary 4.
Soaking up the sun up in my chlorophyll. I'm a plant and I wanna get a suntan, baby. Soaking up the sun up in my chlorophyll. And when I'm thirsty, I drink from my roots. And when I'm thirsty, I drink from my roots. So yeah, I'm a plant and I wanna get a suntan, baby. Soaking up the sun up in my chlorophyll. Plants make oxygen for you and me. In the air so we can breathe. Plants make oxygen for you and me. And they put it in the air so we can breathe. Plants use carbon dioxide. Plants use carbon dioxide, yeah. I'm a plant and I wanna get a suntan, baby. Soaking up the sun up with my chlorophyll. Photosynthesis.
What is this?
It's the way that a plant can grow. A plant, it needs four things, so here we go. Number one, carbon dioxide. It gets it from the air. Number two, lots of sunlight. Hanging out like it doesn't care. Number three, water to drink. Absorbs it through its roots. Number four, minerals that it also takes in through its roots. It also takes in through its roots. I'm a plant and I wanna get a suntan, baby. Soaking up the sunlight with my chlorophyll. I'm a plant and I wanna get a suntan, baby. Soaking up the sunlight with my chlorophyll. And when I'm thirsty, I drink through my roots. And when I'm thirsty, I drink through my roots. Oh yeah, I'm a plant and I wanna get a suntan, baby. Soaking up the sun up with my chlorophyll. Soaking up the sun up with my chlorophyll. Soaking up the sun up with my chlorophyll. Soaking up the sun up with my chlorophyll.
Sun, water, soil, air. How beautifully they work in unison. There was a garden, a pretty garden, filled with bright and beautiful flowers. You would think that such a garden would be a happy place. But no, it wasn't. Why? You wonder why? Well, it's not for me to tell you, but for you to watch the children of Primary 3 present to you Harmony in the Garden.
In a garden, there were many plants with pretty flowers. The flowers nodded their heads and shook and swayed with the lovely breeze. It was a happy garden.
Cause
was starting to droop.
Yes, I'm not feeling good. My friends are also not feeling good.
What do I tell us? Maybe we can help you feel better.
We want to make seeds so new plants can grow. We need pollen to make seeds.
But we haven't got any pollen.
Of course, we will start our pollen with you.
Thank you so much. Now we can make a lot of seeds.
Wait, wait. It's not so easy. We have a problem.
Yes, we have a problem.
What is the problem?
Don't you get it? How is the pollen going to come from there to us?
Exactly. We can't move, nor can they.
Oh dear, this was a problem. Plants cannot move. So how could the pollen be shared? The flowers become very sad. Buzz.
One of the flowers had a great idea. No, a brilliant idea.
What is it? What is the brilliant idea? Tell me.
No, I will not tell you. Let's hear it from the flowers.
Hey, bee, we need your help. We need pollen too. Can you bring us some, please?
This is a brilliant idea, Bee. Drink all the nectar you want. Take all the pollen you want. But please take some pollen to our flower friends over there.
Of course, but I'm a small bee. There are many flowers. I need help.
We are the
flying from one flower to another flower, carrying pollen and sipping nectar too. The flowers were so happy too.
This is wonderful. The hummingbirds help me to get so much of pollen.
Yes, they are helping us. Now you can make lots of seeds.
Yes, so new plants can grow.
The hummingbirds hummed away as they flew around the flowers, but their happy humming sound disturbed the wind.
Whoosh, 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 whoosh.
Hey, what's going on here?
We are taking pollen from one flower to another flower.
Hey, that's my job. I will carry the pollen when I blow.
Okay, then do that. Come on, wind. Blow, blow the pollen around.
Okay, I will do just that.
Thank you so much, Vin.
Yes, thank you for taking the pollen to our flower friends over there.
Yes, thank you.
You are welcome. I like throwing pollen around.
Now we have lots of pollen. We can make lots of seeds.
The flowers became excited. The bees, the hummingbirds, and the wind were helping them.
The wind blew about happily teasing the flowers. The hummingbirds flew about busily. The bright sun smiled up in the sky. The garden became such a happy, busy, buzzing place.
Delightful, wasn't it? How the buzzing bees, the hummingbirds, the whimsical wind all came together to make pollination happen. So plants could make seeds, so new plants could grow. Mother Nature's just amazing in weaving together varied elements to create unique ecosystems. She works her magic in the animal kingdom too. It's time now for us to explore the vibrant, colorful, flamboyant, perky, and beautiful world of birds. Be entertained by the birds of primary too, as they present their life cycle to you.
A nest were many.